In this video, we're going to learn how to use the insert footnote and insert endnote options from within Microsoft Word. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump right in. I have a document here where I want to insert a footnote. And what this footnote is going to represent for me is it's going to reference a YouTube video that I've created. So I'm going to select the insert button and I'm going to select my footnote option. If you don't have this option, you may need to search for it in the search menu, or you may also need to search for the endnote option. So let's do the footnote first. When I insert that footnote, it numbers it, it links it, and it gives me a location at the bottom of this particular page that I can add that content. And what I'm going to say is this post was written from the YouTube video. How to use the crop tool. And I'm going to highlight that, right click, select link, and paste in my YouTube link for that page. And that's how you insert a footnote. Now this will be accessible to a screen reader in Microsoft Word, and it will remove a lot of trouble that we might have when taking it to PDF. So something else I've been trying to do here is in the table breakdown of steps, I'm also going to insert an end note. So to do that, I'm going to select the insert end note option, which will put a element of, I have a lowercase I, can adjust this, and it will put this end note at the very end of the document. And I'm going to say something like, these steps were summarized from the YouTube video, and I'm gonna paste my hyperlink in there. Now, something that we can do is if we wanted to adjust some of these endnote options, I can right click the little endnote option and we can select note options. And from here, we can determine where the endnotes go. So we can put them at the end of a section if you've added section breaks in your document, or you can add them to the end of the document, sort of building a master list of references. You can change the columns. You can also change the number layout. I actually want to change the number layout to be A, B, and C. The numbering will be continuous, or we can have it set to restart at each section. And we're gonna apply the changes to the whole document and select apply. So that updated my endnote to be the letter A, and it's now at the top of my heading content here as an endnote. That concludes today's video on how to insert a footnote and an endnote in Microsoft Word 365, the desktop version. If you want to find out how I can help you get accessible, take a look at the link in the description of this video. And as always, I can be your personal accessibility expert. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.